Hi guys, Steve here from TSM, Clicks Gear Models. Gonna do an October, February update. But before I do, I need to tidy this mess up. I haven't been here for a while. Stuff going on, birthdays, etc, etc, and just stuff. So before I do anything else, I'm gonna tidy up and I'll come back to you in a minute. Right, so we're back and I've tidied the shed, sort of. Well, I've just tidied up the back a bit. It's now Saturday, started yesterday, Friday, Saturday, and it's absolutely chucking it down, and I've just discovered that I've got a leak in my shed. So that's pleased me to no end. Just seems to be one thing after another at the moment. It's just, stuff just get me down. So also, well, we've got Telford coming up. What's that, next week, this weekend, I think. I won't be going. I'm just skimping this time and I can't afford to go, so I just can't go. So I've got no money to buy anything, and I know you shouldn't have to buy anything, but you can't go to these things and not come away empty-handed, so I just can't afford it at the moment. It looks like now I've got to sort out funds to try and get a new shed, more than anything else, because I've got no room indoors to do any of this. I haven't got spare rooms, which I did, because I'd love to be indoors, be a lot warmer, because now it's winter months, it's getting a bit colder. So without further ado, just I'll move the camera around and I'll show you what's been happening. I did get my, as it was my birthday, September, I got some money for that, and I bought a couple of things, well, one thing really, and then the other stuff is just bits and pieces to go on with what I've already got. Yeah, so we'll get there and have a look, shall we? Right, so we have the Airbus A400M by Revel, 172. I have got the fuselage together and the inside, and I'm getting all the pings, and I've put in the micro SMDs in here. Now these need to go behind two glass windows, which I've got to put in, and then we will put the landing gear in and button that up, but this all needs to be sprayed inside. But I have put the wiring in through. Now this was sprayed red for the flashing light, but where I've sprayed over and then sanded, I need to repaint with a bit of red clear. Quite a lot of seams in this, probably can't tell from this picture, but yeah, a lot of seams, and now I've had to do a lot of filling and sanding and filling and sanding. Also what I've done is I have put in the switch for the micro SMDs in the bottom, and I've got to do another one, put another switch in there, which will be for the propellers and the 3mm lights. But yeah, so that works, and we've got a 3-volt battery clip in there as well. It's all got to be tidied up, and you've got to put all the heat shrink on there and everything as well, just to tidy it all up. But that was just purely just to check that the battery is working fine, as you can see. And then obviously that will go up in there and be secured in there somehow. Not entirely sure at the moment how, but we shall see. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. So that's the, let's just put that in there like that. Put all that in there, it's a bit tidier. But it is a bit of a mess, but it will be that all these wires will go away, and then it will be literally just buttoned up like so, and so therefore you shouldn't see any of the wires. So that's just holding there quite nicely. Maybe I might just have some small something over there, a bit of tape, maybe coloured tape, so you can't really see it. Just to hold it in, because you're not going to see that, because it's going to be literally like that on the ground. Bit of a bad camera angle to show you that one. So then we got the wing. Now, this wing, yeah. I have had some problems, not necessarily with the wing itself, but more with this. This was supposed to be a simple flash circuit board I got off eBay. It's only a couple of pounds, and it's supposed to flash the LEDs. Now I put in a wire in there, and then I've wired up a small SMD to go on it as well. And wired it all up. I checked with a couple of people that I've done it correctly, and they all seem to think that I had. But when I put some power for it, the SMD, it lit but didn't flash. So not sure what's gone on there. I contacted the seller, and he hasn't got any more in stock, so he's refunded me, which is fine, which is great, you know. That's nice customer service, but it doesn't solve my issue, and I can't wait any longer. I spoke to Jennifer from Small Scale Lights. Actually, she was the person helping me just try and wind that up from what she could see and what I was telling her. But she can do me a circuit board, but it's £20, and £20 just to power to two flashing lights on the end of each wing. It's just, nah, I can't do that. So I've decided in the end to omit those lights. I won't have them at all. We will just have the lights in the two ends here, which will be fine. So I've started gluing. I've glued this wing down. This one is done as well, but obviously just clamped in place. So when that is done, then we will go around sanding everything down, all the joints, putting some filler in where I think it's going to need, because there's going to be some in there by the looks of it. There's a couple little gaps, and also perhaps in the back of the wings as well, and then just touching up, sanding down, etc. And then I will need to put the lenses over the SMDs there, and then tape them over and do exactly the same on this wing. And then once that's done and the main fuselage is sanded properly from what and we've got the hack, then I can marry the two together, and then we can think about priming the whole thing and then going for the paint. Not entirely sure what paint to get at the moment. I have got the colour chart, but I'm not sure. I want to see if I can get something equivalent in Tamiya. But to get the, for the colour chart, to get the main colour, you have to mix paints, and I think I can get one from Hattica, but it's only a small paint pot, and for the amount of size, the size plane this is, I'm going to need more than one small paint pot. So I just need to work that one out and what I'm going to do. So that's the Airbus. Now, put that over there. As I said, it was my birthday in September, my 50th birthday. And I'm a part of the birthday club on ISM, International Scale Modeler, and I was on their show the week before. And as my birthday gift, I got this. It's the Polar Lights 1350 Klingon Katinga class battle cruiser. Good old Norman, he knows me, he knows I love my Star Trek, and he knows that I've wanted this kit for a long time. So yeah, they got me this, and I am, yeah, love it. It's gonna be a great kit. Is going to go along with my 1350 Enterprise refit, and I also have, excuse me, guys, I also have 1350 Bird of Prey, which is going to go, but this is quite, this is huge. It's it should be in total just about just under 2 foot in length. So this is going to be a big kit. Now you can buy the lighting kit for it from Polar Lights, which is £100 from Hatton's. I think it's £100 from most places. But what I've seen of that lighting kit is not very good. It's just, it's a very, very basic lighting kit, and for £100, it's not worth it. So I'm pretty sure I can get some bits and pieces together, some lighting, and I will do my own lighting kit. But this is going to be one for next year, I think, because there's a few things I want to do before I start any new kits. So that's that. And then also for, I got some birthday money, as you do, and I bought this. You can see that, I'm not sure, but it's the Trumpy, again, 1/350 HMS hood. Now, the reason why I bought this, and yeah, you can, don't know if you can see that there, I've got a leak in my shed, as we just discovered, and it's just starting to get on there, so I need to move some of this stuff. That's damn annoying. So yes, going back to this, the reason why I wanted this, I actually want this, and I want to get the Bismarck as well in the same scale. Now the reason why I got this is because before Hood was sunk, my late grandfather served on HMS Hood. I'm not exactly sure of the time scale he served on her, but he did, and so I want to build this. I want to get a good amount of photo etch for it. I've seen that you can get a deck, wooden deck bit for it as well. I'm not sure about that, but I definitely want to get the wooden, the photo etch, and perhaps the brass barrels. But this is going to be a long-term build. This is, let's just have a look at it a little bit. I'm going to do some reviews on the two kits I've got. But it is going to be a big kit, and it's going to be, I might call it a legacy kit. But she's still quite big, but at the same time, she's quite small. As in the parts and everything are very small, but I really would like to get the photo etch for it, because excuse me, I'm gonna go on camera, I yawn. If you can just see the stacks for the funnels, they're all closed, and I know the P kit, this is all totally open, you can see in, and so yeah, that is something I want to do for this. So I want to get the P, and yeah, this is going to be a nice long-term slow burner kit. Take my time on this one, get it done right and properly. What's that in there? Well, oh, that's just on the seat for that. So yeah, it's looks a lovely kit, but like I say, it's poignant to me for the fact that my grandfather served on it, and that's why I want to do this. Might say, well, if my grandfather did serve it, well, it was sunk by the Bismarck, why get the Bismarck? Well, because the Bismarck and the hood go hand in hand in my eyes. So yeah, let's just put that up there. Let's get into the fact that that is getting wet is getting a bit annoying. What else? Oh yeah, just the other day I got some more goggles. Needed these, mine is broke. Just beyond stupidness repair. Oh yeah, I got some more paints, but the paints is for a long term project, but I saw them reduced. Going back to the Airbus, which I hadn't on, is I've got the propellers sprayed up, and they're all looking good. I've got to give them a matte coat, matte varnish, and then I will get the decals. Going back to the Airbus now again, I was going to do it as an RAF Airbus, but upon searching the internet, I found the decals for it, but it's £21 for a decal sheet, and of that decal sheet you only use not even a quarter of it, because it comes with markings for four different countries markings, and £21 for a decal sheet when you can use a quarter of it is just, again, I just think it's a bit ridiculous. You can get the RAF Centenary 100 decal sheet for just under £10. Thought about doing that, but then it's not going to look, I don't know if it's going to look any good with that, with the bright red in the 100 on it. It's not, I don't know, I've got to think about that. If I don't, it will just be out of the box decal sheets with the German markings, the Luftwaffe markings. But so, yep, let's just turn the camera back to a different one, different camera angle. 1 second. Right, so yeah, that is my October, beginning of November update. Building is slow. I'm not out here as much due to work, tired. Start my new job. I'm in a secondary school now, and it's a new systems and everything like that, so I'm trying to get used to all the new stuff. And I've got a team of eight to get to know and to manage. So that's taking a lot out of me at the moment. And then sometimes when I get out of here, I just want to just chill, or I'll stick TV on and just watch YouTube. Or on a Friday night, I'll watch the ISM show. So sometimes just I'm out here just chilling, not actually modelling. This is getting frustrating a little bit doing this, but I can't put another model back in the box, guys. I've got also, if I did that, there'd be 1, 2, 3, 4 in the box. So no, I can't do that. It's, you don't buy a model just to start it and then not complete it. Well, I don't anyway. That's never been in my intention. So, oh god, yawning again. Oh, I'm so sorry. So I want to get this one done. I was going to do a dio for it, not sure at the moment. I'll see how I go once I get back into painting it and get the decals done, see how I go from there. But after done that, I want to get back to the Tomcat. And if I don't get back to the Tomcat, it's got to be the Star Destroyer. But the Star Destroyer is a bit of a soul destroyer, drilling out all the holes for the fiber optics. But you know, it's what it is. I start to do these things and got to get back into it. What else? Like I said, not going to Telford this year, just really can't afford it. Although I've got a new job, I still got stuff to pay out, and we had our 50th birthday to pay out for, and we went away for the weekend and stuff like that. We got Christmas coming up, and some stuff that needs doing around the house as well. So, and now looking by the judge of this shed, I'm gonna have to try and sort out that leaky roof. Might have to put some new felt on the roof. I'd love to get a new shed. A little bit bigger, but you know, hey ho, I think I'll have to stick with what I've got at the moment. There's other stuff that's more of a priority. And really and truly, going to Telford, I don't want to buy any more kits. I've got enough kits. I know there's lots of people out there who've got loads and loads of kits, but no, I've got enough kits to keep me going for a couple of years. So obviously you get like a certain kit come up and you want to get that, so, but at the moment I don't think there is anything. I had thought about doing one of the part builds, but I don't know, we'll see what money constraints are, because I'd love to do the X-Wing. Or I saw the other day on YouTube that you can do the DB5 from James Bond, Goldfinger. That looks cracking. I'd love to do that. You know, I've already done the Mustang. I'm sure it's the same scale. But yeah, I love James Bond. I'd love to do the Mustang. No, not the Mustang, the DB5. It's got all the little bits and pieces in it, apparently. Rotating number plates, gun emplacements, ejector seat and everything. Quite well detailed. So, but again, it's all down to money constraints. But other than that, I've got a little kitchen. And I'm on filming, I'm not yawning. I mean, I'm yawning, but when I'm not filming, I'm fine. So yeah, because I've only got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, nearly 20 kits. That's enough to keep me going for some time. What I need now is really bits, equipment and stuff like that, and maybe paints and etc. So I've got to look into what paints to get for this. I'd like to get a Tamiya paint equivalent, or look at what the Hataka, I think it's Hataka, I'm probably saying that completely wrong, what colour paint that would be for the RAF grey. But it'd be all that sort of, same sort of colours, RAF grey, the German grey. It's all pretty one standard colour really for those, for the modern aircraft. What else? Not a lot really. Thinking of closing down the Facebook group due to the fact that it seems to be the same half a dozen people posting and no one else seems to be posting. It's just, I put up, I do schedule posts for people to interact with, but just people aren't even interacting with that really. You get the odd, like I say, you get the normal, I think it's half a dozen that do, but other than that, it's not building. Significantly slowed down on people. Maybe that's me, I don't know. It's just getting to the point where I'm like, do I need to be doing this? I've got a lot of other stuff going on. I've got my Slimming World going on as well, because I'm trying to lose a bit of the old chub. And so I've lost 3 stone so far. It's slowed down a little bit at the moment, but I need to lose at least another 3. So I'm trying to concentrate on that as well. I need to be doing more posts for that, because I've got a Facebook page for that, along my Instagram. So I don't know at the moment. It's just getting to the point where I've got to manage this, got to manage that, and it's getting a lot, and like I say, it's just time consuming. Equipment is failing as well, so I need to just, my laptop is just practically dead. If this actually uploads at a decent rate of what I intend it to load, I'll be very, very surprised, because it's just absolutely pants. It's not the actual video editing software, it's the actual laptop. It's just so, it's antiquated now. I've recorded some of this on my phone, some of it on the cameras that I've got here. I'll be very surprised if this does actually upload. But hey, that's it for now really. Not a lot to say. I did want to, like I say, I was going to be trying to do more videos and stuff like that. I did say that in the last one. Hasn't happened. No excuse really, just haven't had the time, haven't really. I've wanted to do stuff, but just like I say, I get frustrated quite easily with the fact that my computer is just so. And that is a big factor, because I get frustrated when things don't do what I feel they should do, and then I just get like, and then I just give up because I can't afford to buy a new computer. I'd love to. I looked into trying to get a refurbished one, but even that's a bit out of my price range. And then I looked at maybe building one, but even then that's going to cost me, what am I, 200-300 quid, and it's just, it's money I haven't got right now, and it's just all, yeah, it's just, so yeah, I just want a model, and even then I can't do that. It's just getting frustrating and stuff. Stuff. Anyway, so that's the update for this month. I'll try and see you all soon. Take care. Bye.